company to use it, right? Because that Advantage plan is paying for all that, that claims and processing. So our Advantage plans, they start at zero premium, and they range up from there to $251 here in the Rochester region. I'm gonna be highlighting and really featuring our zero premium plan. It's called our Blue Choice Select plan. Why? Because it's by far our most popular plan, right? under that zero premium plan, obviously, zero, right? You're not paying anything additionally to Medicare, especially for folks that are new to Medicare. The one question that usually jumps in right here is, you know, how do you offer a zero premium plan? You know, what's in it for you as a health plan to offer a product at zero? How do you make any money on that, right? Well, the Advantage plans are all subsidized by Medicare, okay? And it's a substantial subsidy that we receive from Medicare from the government. It's over $800 a month per member on average. Okay, what goes into that subsidy is your Part B premium. So that's not a sunk cost, right? It's all built into your benefits. But the additional funding is what you've worked and paid into. It's part of your, you know, working career and paying into that, that Medicare contribution. So substantial fundings behind these programs, right? That's what allows us to build and develop plans, and we've been fortunate to maintain and manage costs, and that's what's really kept that zero there for us. Okay, so you're not getting something for nothing, right? These are your hard-earned dollars, my hard-earned dollars. You take advantage of it, you're probably not going to be there when I get there, right? but that is what really helps subsidize and fund these programs, okay? So there's nothing hidden there, right? Final component of Medicare is Part D, right? That's the prescription drug component. Very important piece of Medicare, because once you're Medicare eligible, if you have any lapse in prescription drug coverage, you have any break in coverage, you don't select the Part D plan timely, every month that goes by in which you fail to maintain a creditable prescription drug plan, if it's something that you add in the future, Medicare will go back and assess you a late enrollment penalty. Okay, that penalty is on a monthly basis for every month that has lapsed where you have not had that creditable prescription drug plan. Okay, the good news is there's several avenues where you can satisfy that Part D benefit. group coverage, most group plans have creditable prescription drug benefits. Okay, there's standalone Part D plans. It's just a separate prescription drug plan you can use with original Medicare. VA benefits, military coverage, those are all viable, credible Part D plans. Okay, what I'm gonna be focusing on though, and another appealing feature to that Part C program, the Advantage plans, the majority of the policies also incorporate prescription drug coverage. Okay, so the four plans I'm highlighting today, they all have Part D coverage included. So I do not see a lot of people, you know, that face that Part D penalty. I mean, there's a lot of education there about it. But with the popularity of the Advantage plans on the individual market and us having like a zero premium plan, right, you can go get a program like that that includes Part D at no additional cost to original Medicare. It's also filling some of those gaps within original Medicare A and B. So added medical, but also that the Part D benefit. So A, B, C, and D, right? Easiest way to break it down, A and B, that's what the government provides you. C and D, that's your private insurance. So prescription drug coverage, you do have to obtain through a private plan, right? You do not do that through Social Security Administration and Medicare. It's not actually, you know, a government benefit there, right? So that should set a pretty good foundation. If you can understand how A, B, C, and D works, everything should really fall into place here pretty quickly. Original Medicare, as I mentioned, for both Part A and Part B, you're gonna have a deductible. And then from there, depending on the length of stay in the hospital, services that are provided, you'll see additional co-insurance and co-pays. Right off the top, the Advantage plan is gonna, you know, fill that high deductible, for example, under your Part A benefit, okay? Under the Advantage plans, pay a co-pay. Doctor visits, labs, x-rays, vision, hearing, right? All co-pays through the plans. So pretty rich benefit there. Okay, the other appealing feature through an Advantage plan is there's a capped amount. And there's something called an out-of-pocket maximum. That's basically a ceiling that that private plan is setting for you. So a lot of people, you know, aren't even gonna come close to this figure, but you have a bad year, insurance is there for those catastrophic needs, right? You're gonna have that ceiling through that private plan. So if your medical cost ever reaches that limit, you're covered in full following. Original Medicare is unlimited. So you have that bad year, right? You're gonna pay on Medicare's fee schedule with no caps, no restrictions there. So a few appealing features to the Advantage programs. Again, with an Advantage plan, right, your health plan's primary. And so It's all you carry with you is that ID card. Billing claims come right through the plan. And then again, the four products I'm taking you through also has that RX piece, right? So your prescription drug coverage is included. There is another option out there though. So before I dig into the Advantage plans, we're gonna shift gears real quick here and talk about an alternative to an Advantage plan, and they're called supplement plans, also known as Medigap policies. Anybody heard of a supplement plan, Medigap plan? See that shape, yes, no. not nearly as popular here in upstate New York. Reason being, they're looked at really more as like a pay now type of policy. So generally you're gonna pay a little bit higher premium for those programs. Now if you're gonna pay a higher premium, what do you expect in return is probably a pretty high level benefit, and that can certainly be the case with supplement plans. But structurally and functionally, they're gonna operate a little bit different from an Advantage program. Okay, the main difference is that under a supplement plan, a Medigap plan, so that's used interchangeably, it means the same thing, Medicare is the primary payer for your insurance. Right, so you go to the doctor, in this case, he'd actually present your red, white, and blue card. Medicare pays their piece first, the supplement plan pays secondary to that. Okay, the other major difference here is they don't include Part D, so that prescription drug component, that's a separate plan that you have to go out and add on. Okay, so I always tell people, you're gonna have a few more balls in the air with a supplement program, right? Because really, in most cases, you're gonna have three forms of insurance. Medicare paying first, then your supplement plan to bridge some of those medical costs, and then separate Part D, again, all of which carry premiums. So functionally, you know, it's gonna be a little more involved than that of an Advantage plan, because the Advantage plan ties it all together. So why would someone look at a supplement plan? And this is the first time I'll bring it up, but you'll probably hear me say it about 10 more times throughout the presentation, but it's really utilization driven. And utilization is what drives the shift with insurance. Okay, it doesn't matter if you're buying your car insurance, your homeowner's insurance, or your health insurance, right? When you're looking at plans and premiums, right, how do you justify paying higher premiums? Or I'm sorry, lower premiums? How do you justify that? It's through additional utilization, right? If you're gonna pay more now, right, you're gonna do so because you're thinking that maybe you're gonna have some of those medical needs, you know, down the line. So utilization is really what steers things here. But when someone's generally looking at a Medigap or a supplement plan, it's usually more of like your very, very high utilization. So higher cost procedures. So a couple of things that'll really trigger me to shift gears from an Advantage program, a couple, you know, keywords here, chemo, radiation. Right? Under an Advantage program for chemo and radiation follows Medicare guidelines where you're responsible for 20% of the cost. When you go in for radiation treatment, say three times a week, Don't hold me to the numbers. I'm just going to spitball some numbers for you. But let's say it's $1,000 per radiation treatment. You pay 20%, it's $200, right? You're doing that a few times a week, you know, multiple times a month. Well, that's going to add up. So in that case, is where someone may look more towards a supplement plan. Okay, you pay a little bit higher premiums generally, okay, but you can get a high level return from a benefit standpoint. So as an example, there's one plan on the supplement market. It's called Plan F. F is in Frank. A Plan F will pay the full cost following Original Medicare. So anything covered under Original Medicare A and B, that Plan F is going to pick up the additional cost. Now, Plan F through Excellus here is over $280 a month. Right? Pay now, you can get that high premium. So if you're going to pay that higher premium, how you justify it is through, you know, that higher utilization generally. So that's usually what steers things over. But again, I'm going to focus on the Advantage plans, right? Because where the premiums sit for the Advantage programs. Certainly very, very popular. Again, a very rich benefit because no deductible for medical, really follow more of a copay structure. So a lot of people are not justified to pay those higher premiums under a supplement plan. So that's what I'm gonna focus on. But if you do wanna learn more about a supplement plan, see me following. We can dig into a little more detail there. I can provide you with some additional literature. Everything that we have here in front of you in this kit is all geared around the Advantage program. So as I mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, all Medicare plans are regional. Okay, so focusing on the Rochester-based plans, which is Monroe, Livingston, Wayne, Ontario, Seneca, and Yates counties. Six county radius. All right, first quiz for you here today, is something I brought up kind of with the opening statements here. In this blue shaded area, how many of the hospitals do we contract with here locally? You gotta pass the first test.
All of them.
All of them. There we go. All of them. right? Same thing from a pharmacy standpoint, right? A lot of flexibility, all the major pharmacies are giving you that right there. So when you see that blue shaded area, right, gives you a lot of peace of mind, a lot of flexibility here locally. But that blue shaded area is also gonna be your in-network benefits. So we're gonna shift over to our Advantage programs where we have four plans that all include prescription drug coverage. Okay, but before we even dig into, you know, benefits, first thing to really understand is the different plan types. So we have our HMO products under our Value and Value Plus. HMO is a health maintenance organization. That means you have in-network coverage. Right? So in-network, you're in this blue shaded area. Right? A lot of flexibility there. Okay? Now, whenever I say in-network and, you know, talk about like a regional benefit, generally the first question I get is, well, what happens if I'm traveling? Right? What if I'm outside of that 6-county radius? And the good news is there are travel benefits with all the Advantage programs. In the event of an emergency, you're covered worldwide. So you have worldwide emergency benefits. Part of an emergency event, we treat you and bill you just as if you're here in-network. Right? I'm out of the area. I'm overseas. I get in a car accident, requires hospitalization, surgeries, whatever it may be.